on demand. When I lift both doors and I hit on the gas and zoom, zoom, get out the fast lane, boom, boom.
What's going on, you guys? And today, it's your boy Paul.Shomes here. Today, baby, this is a revamp of that bullshit story that I put on YouTube when the officer nearly shot me to death inside of school. So we're gonna revamp this bitch. We're gonna talk about it how it is, and we're gonna keep the main thing in this story. So this involves piggery and policing, bad policing. You know, your boy has to defend his honor and walk down to that school. So I just happened to have black sweatpants on, a black jacket, a black shirt, a black head cap. I just happen to look like I'm an intruder because I'm black and I have black on. You get me? So as I'm walking out of my home with this shit on, I ain't realized that. And I didn't think they were the type of profile in school because we all black in there. And the population is mostly black and they ain't got no white chicks in there. I didn't want to go to that school in from the beginning. And that's why I made that song, I Get High. And I talked about how I was an intruder and shit like that. So basically, I head down, I walk down there, by the way. And I get in, they scan me in, la-di-da-di-da. I'm there to talk to my coach on some wrestler to coach preference, wrestler to coach sit down type shit. So because my math teacher screwed me. So as I get out the office and walk the hall, this is a new white lady. I think she's the new one. This is my senior year. This is the end, close to the end of the year. This bitch want to profile me. I think she's new. I think she's going to be one of those new step-ins next year for 2023. She profiles me. She's like, hey, take that thing off your head. You're not supposed to have any head caps in school. You're not supposed to wear any hats in school. That was unusual. The bitch is just stopping me. She's like, are you supposed to be in here? Did you check in with the office? This bitch is never profiling me. I've been to that school 100 billion times, and I've never been profiled by any Karens. So I got somebody out of an office because I felt scared. And when you feel scared, you got to go and do the right thing. Go get somebody, get a black woman. I got a black woman of stature in that school, and she stopped fucking with me. So I was able to make it to my coach. But as I was, he wasn't in his room. So I was just pacing because I was waiting for him out there because I wanted to wrestle my last couple of matches, even if I didn't wrestle the whole season because of a fucking fucked up math teacher fucking me up for the season. And she's stopping me and bypassing the system. And I should have went to the principal and told the principal and told different people that she was doing this, but it fucked me over in the long run. I tried to tell the county, I emailed the Board of Education. It didn't work out. I should have called them. I should have called the principal. I should have talked to different people. But I just, in the long end, when I got out of high school, I realized that. But story ain't over. When I was pacing in that hallway, there's a camera pointing down at me, and one of my teacher's rooms are there. I forgot her name. She's a good teacher. She taught me economics and whatever. Her room's there. I could have just walked in there and stopped pacing, and I could have just chilled out, but I wouldn't stop pacing because I was worried about my wrestling career. I was worried about becoming, at least wrestling, like the couple of matches, getting my dignity back, because 11th grade I was supposed to be state champion, but COVID hit, and in 12th grade I was really supposed to be state champion, but shit happened and COVID and bad grades and fucked up old lady teachers. Like I said, the teacher was fucked up. Should have went to the principal. Should have went to the county. So now, in the hallway, pacing, camera looking down at me. They're like, I hear this bald head motherfucker that they call him the dean. His walkie-talkie, bloop, bloop. Yes, I'm down here. We see him. I'm like, oh shit, they got me. And I'm not even doing anything wrong for them to get me. It's like, oh shit, I'm be another victim of Black Lives Matter. I'm be another black person on a poster, on a t-shirt. Pray for Paul Smith. It's like, golly. So that motherfucker comes down here with the fat police pig officer. Then they start talking to me. And when they start talking to me, it's in reference to why I'm out there, why I'm outside the classroom pacing. And it's probably because the white lady saw me in all black pacing and like I was an intruder, but I was a student there actually. So the officer, and first of all, Kelly talked to me. Kelly's a black dude. Dean Kells. That's what I'm going to call him. I'm not going to call him his first, what he's known by, his alias. So I'm going to call him Dean Kells. Dean Kells stopped. He's a black dude. He stopped and talked to me. That's the dean. Then the other guy, the fat police, he had some insight, but he really didn't know what was going on. But basically, I could have died over a wrestling season because this fucked up old lady decided that during COVID, because I had a 69, she wasn't going to raise it up and I had the paperwork to change it. So I could have died over that because she was trying to put me in a better class because the biggest money game was being played because I was never in a regular class. She was just getting she was getting money off of me, and the individualized education plan was getting money off of me because I was in that class. So any other way, I could have been a victim because I was in there valiantly fighting while the Baltimore County education system did not give a fuck. I mean, I emailed the school board. They didn't respond back to me, but I should have went to the principal after. It was an outright dastardly situation. I was in the hallway with them talking for a couple minutes. He escorted me out. He didn't put his hands on me, which I'm glad. The officer had his hand on his gun the whole entire time. I ain't gonna lie about shit. Like, I thought I was gonna end up on a t-shirt or in a BLM post. That's why I was talking to you about BLM and t-shirts and shit like that. But the fucking video I had up was a me in the aftermath, probably like a day after or two days after. I wasn't in the right mindset after. I just felt like extremely under distress because it was a situation of where life or death. And I had some headphones in my jacket, and if I would have made the wrong move, that nigga would have clapped me and I would have ended up on a t-shirt. But yeah, it's just, we gotta fix our school system, education system. They gotta get that old bitch out of there from ruining people's high school careers and football careers. And I didn't play football that year, but wrestling would have held me down. She whispered in my ear, the bitch is evil. She whispered in my ear. She said, you're not gonna be wrestling. She's so fucking evil. We gotta change that narrative in Baltimore County education system. At least make the shit a 1.0 GPA average to be eligible. I don't give a fuck. We got to change it. And the thing about it was just so crazy. She had so much power. I felt like she had so much power, but the administrators were there. They were there to help. And it was just crazy, man. Nobody really could help. I went to the assistant principal. He couldn't help. And I didn't really want to go to that big forehead rhinoceros principal because I felt like she wasn't going to help after Miss Carrier left. So I was left with being stranded in my own pool of thoughts and what to do. Was just confusing. So she took over New World Order, and at the same time she almost got me clapped. So to her, a big fuck you, and I hope you retire. And you run over something and it's like a whole bunch of spikes in the road, and your car does a 360 flip over and you end up in front of a big four-wheeler, and that bitch just collides into your shit, and then you end up in a pool of blood. I wish the worst. I wish the motherfucking worst. That was my breakout year, my breakout wrestling year, and it can't be forgiven. Like, comment, and subscribe.
bye.